permission.
You do?
Yeah, the owners of the building. The owners of the building.
Owner of the building. Mm-hmm. Can I see that written? Well, that
I don't know. Oh, yeah, sure.
Written?
Yeah, it's called the U.S. Constitution. Yeah.
Oh, the owner? Oh!
Yeah.
The Constitution owns this building.
Well, the people do. We the people. Yeah, we the taxpayers. Wow.
Congratulations. You win. Record all you want.
And you graduated high school. I'm not gonna yell at you. It's my favorite.
She's funny.
I don't scream at people. Ooh, a map.
She's funny.
1:35.
Lesson of the day: don't work in public if you don't want to be found. There he is. She's screaming at us like this, like, but see what I was doing, sir, was I was just getting like the general layout, and then she started screaming at us.
Okay, thank you.
I mean, I was just getting the general layout of the public building,
okay.
And I guess she didn't like it, yeah. And we couldn't hear her, so that's when she called us over, so.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, it's in public. I mean, you have body cams. Yeah, I mean, there's probably 1,000 cameras recording me right now, so, yeah.
There's say that you can't film.
No, I mean, after she starts going like this, you call attention to the camp.
Settings error cost a company $1.5 million. I don't want it to happen.
They circumvent our rights every way they can, just like the whole Pennsylvania versus men's bullshit. Guys, don't let cops force you out of the vehicle and try to just say, we have the right to take you. No, they don't. They have to reasonably believe that you're armed and dangerous to do that, period. So they're letting you out, I think. Taking this picture. Wow, really? I guess against the law in America to walk down the road at 2 or 3 in the morning.
space I don't need for me or him to.
I need to defend ourselves, okay?
Defend yourself, please.
I'm going to if you invade my space and you put me in fear. So don't do that. That'd be a bad move.
Behind your face.
That'd be a. Joe, de-escalate, Joe. Joe, de-escalate. Because now I got to fill out another request to get that.
Thank you.
But
what do you do?
I do what I do.
What's that?
I mind my business, same as you should be doing.
What's that?
Minding my business.
Oh, okay.
Same as you should be doing. I can transfer your request for a cell phone. So that's all I need. No, I already got
a FOIA request. She doesn't have a town cell phone.
No, she has a personal one.
Right.
That she's using while she's elected, so now I can get the property.
She's not elected.
She's in a public capacity, Joe. Yeah, how much you want to bet I'm going to get that video?
You're not going to get her cell
phone. I guarantee you I am.
Right.
Guess what? Over 100 requests for cell phone footage of people in public capacity with personal phones. I've got every one. I will get it.
You won't get this one?
Yes, I will.
That's a personal phone.
Yeah, how much you want to bet? You want to bet your job?
Originally, we got called and thought it was for filming of people voting. That's what we originally
said. Yeah, no.
It was definitely something different than that. So, yeah, but I mean,
yeah.
Public building, you know, First Amendment.
The first time I went to Johnson Town Hall over 2 years ago, it was a doozy. Now, it's interesting. Town officials made a call to the Johnston Police Department with a false allegation. An allegation that we were filming voters. It would be a disruption of their voting rights. Which is very interesting, because there was only one person breaking voting laws that day. And that was the mayor himself. Now, take a look at the mayor's shirt. It says Joe, registered nurse. Which is very interesting, because in Rhode Island, a candidate for re-election has to be 100 yards away from the polling place. Joe tried to bypass that and illegally violate state and federal election laws by saying he wasn't there as a candidate. He was there as a registered nurse offering medical support. But that didn't help him. He wound up ultimately losing the election anyways. But in a strange twist of events, his son wound up getting his spot instead. He lost the election due to a couple reasons. Number one, he violated election laws. Number two, the public lost faith in him after our videos went viral. And number three, he absolutely did try and interfere in our records request, to the point where the AG's office had to get involved and put sanctions on the city of Johnston. But we showed up today to figure out if his son had any idea what dear old dad had been up to. Crazy mayor, the attorney general wound up putting sanctions on them for illegally denying a records request, interfering in his own election. I mean, this one was nuts.
Thank you, sir.
By the attorney general's office.
I do not know that.
I was just wondering, does he know that his dad had interfered in his own election?
You do not have permission to record me.
I don't need permission, so. Okay. There's two guys. I don't have permission to record, I guess. That's like a thing that you need now, I guess, is permission to record people in a public place. Oh, he's got the code master, code enforcement.
When you're done, I'll take it and I'll give it to you.
Hey, can I borrow this pen? Thank you. Let's do a record request. Today's date is our perfect. Yeah.
Woke up this morning to an email that said that they were suing me
YouTube is... I think, I don't know if I've met all of you before, but I think I met you before, right? You're very, very nice. General put sanctions on it. It was like a whole big thing. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you very much. We're going to try. You too. You got the office for it. You too. This is where I went in before. It was. They said it was closed to the public, but it wasn't.
The possibility of being attacked in your home.
Oh my god, no! Look to the right, bro.
Oh no!
Oh my god.
What do you do for work, Jason? Oh, we're gonna poke it.
Yeah, that's unconstitutional. Well, yeah, I wonder why can I... What's your attitude, bro? What's your attitude? What's your attitude?
Sir, you can come in.
Come on. Yo, why do you talk to me like that, bro? Did I give you an attitude? Did I give you an attitude? Nah, bro, I don't got that problem, bro. It looks like you have an attitude problem, man. Why do you... Do you treat everybody like that?
No, sir.
Why do you treat me like that?
No, I'm just trying to make sure you understood what this joke...
I get that. I know how to read, but I want to know why. Why is this so constitutional? Yeah, you swore an oath to what I'm doing, dude. You don't care, though. This guy don't comply, dude, with the First Amendment. None of these people here in Florida... disconnect we have, dude. This is why people, you guys are in the hate. This is why you guys are in the hate. This guy was all right. His attitude's all right. But you, I don't know what's your problem. It looks like your wife's cheating on you, dude. You need to tighten up, boy. You need to tighten up, bro. Have a bad day, bro. These guys are unconstitutional as hell, bro. Crazy. I knew it, guys. What did I tell you? I knew it. All this in Florida here, man. All these courthouses here around this area on the West Coast. It's unconstitutional. Behind those, shall we? Okay, cool. What's your name? Nice to meet you. I'm Joey.
Professionals are getting the word out about a sexually transmitted form of ringworm that's newly made its way